string tokenizer. As string tokenizer equals new string tokenizer. What does it take? It takes a string. So let's do like Milan is great. I don't know. Milan is not that great. And now we also need to pass something else, the delimiter. Let's see. I'm assuming that this works just like split, you know. So let's just get rid of that. Let's get rid of this. Just so I have more space for the code, we can open this and we can reduce the size of it. Okay. Because I don't see it from the chat. My chat is over here somewhere and you don't see the chat. And now I'm assuming like string tokenizer, we can create a while loop because as I've seen here, has more tokens. I'm assuming that this will just split whatever you pass into it using this delimiter. And I'm just going to try to use it like while string tokenizer has more tokens. Print out string tokenizer dot, what's the method called? Next token. Okay, let's try this. If it doesn't work, I'm going to have to Google it again, but it does work. We're going to get rid of these got prize thingies. I'm going to comment them out. Milan is not that great. Yeah, Milan is not that great. You know, it just splits it and it has a couple of methods, has more tokens. It just loops through them. And when you ask for next token, it knows where it stopped. You know, we can say we can stop it even before, you know, we can print only three. If we had a for loop, we could have said, you know, when it's three, break out of the loop or something. Again, I've never used this in my life. I just use split, but you can see that it's pretty much similar. You can use it similarly as a split. It just works with two other methods. Split would give you an array, and then you stop when it's the end of the array. This guy has more tokens. So you stop when it's no longer true. And as long as it's true, next token will give you